Ladies and gentlemen, the Kiwanis Club of Tulsa proudly presents the 1990 Miss Oklahoma Pageant, celebrating Susan Powell's 10th anniversary as Miss America. Starring Susan Powell, Miss America 1981. Mignon Merchant Ball, Miss Oklahoma 1986. Miss Oklahoma 1989, Tamara Marler. With David Hines, Dance 2000, Richard Cox and the Miss Oklahoma Orchestra with a song for you.
Coming on, and I'm warning you, it's a victorious, happy and glorious new strain. I feel a song coming on. It's a melody full of the laughter of children out after the rain. You'll hear a tuneful story ringing through you, love. Troubles are gone. Let those heavenly drums go on drumming, 'cause I feel a song coming on.
Miss Oklahoma, Tamara Marler.
You know that we were
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome your 1990 Miss Oklahoma
enchanted land. Deep down in my heart, I hear it say, is this the day?
I'm Mignon Merchant Ball. Thank you. Aren't your contestants beautiful? They are indeed. One of them will travel to Atlantic City in September to compete for the Miss America crown. Which one will she be? Well, let's meet them now.
Good evening. I'm Kimberly Wiles, Miss Altus.
I'm Leanne Jones, Miss Ardmore.
I'm Keely Fry, Miss Arkansas Valley.
I'm Meredith Lee, Miss Broken Arrow.
I'm Jo Jean Brown, Miss Carl Albert Jr. College.
Stephanie Genning, Miss Carnegie.
Hello, I am Dina Tunstall, Miss Central State University of Edmond.
Hi, I'm Jill Rogers, Miss Chickasha.
Good
Good evening. I'm Marianne Daly, Miss Claremore.
Good evening. I'm Carrie Skinner, Miss Clinton.
Good evening. I'm Tamara Parkhurst, Miss Collinsville.
Hello. I'm Holly Howard from Connor State College.
Eastern Oklahoma State College.
I'm Marcia Harrell, Miss Elk City.
Hi, I'm Michelle Rudd, Miss Enid.
Hello, I'm Erin Patterson, Miss Jinx.
I'm Marnie Ward, Miss Kiamishi Country.
Good evening, I'm Deanna Luckinville, Miss Lake Hudson.
Good evening, I'm Rayetta Carruthers, Miss Langston University.
Good evening, I'm Andrea Lynn Caldwell, Miss Lawton.
Good evening, I'm Polly Mordecai, Miss McAllister.
Good evening, I'm DeSharmy Carter, Miss Midwest City.
Hello, I'm Beth Fields, Miss Moore.
Hello, I'm Michelle Masteller, Miss Nakoma Park.
I'm Cindy Wall, Miss Norman.
Beth Tompkins, Miss North Central Oklahoma.
Good evening, I'm Ellen Teal, Miss Northeastern State University.
I'm Krista Party, Miss Northern Oklahoma College.
Good evening, I'm Corby Carlin, Miss Northwest Oklahoma.
Good evening, I'm Dana Ogle, Miss Oklahoma City.
Hello, I'm Amy Everett, Miss Oklahoma City University.
Good evening, I'm Tristy Welpley, Miss Oklahoma State University.
I'm Holly Ann Brees, Miss Owosso.
Good evening, I'm Missy Speaker, Miss
I'm Carrie Candace Wright, Miss Queen of the West.
I'm Joellen Washington, Miss Shawnee.
Hi, I'm Alyssa Hunter, Miss Red Carpet Country.
Good evening, I'm Deanne Holmes, Miss Sand Springs.
Good evening, I'm Kimberly Scott, Miss Skytook area.
Good evening, I'm Tamara Walker, Miss Southwestern.
Good evening, I'm Cheryl Cooper, Miss Stevens County.
Good evening, I'm Cynthia White, Miss Stroud.
Good evening, I'm Donna Huffman, Miss Tulsa.
Hello, I'm Gina Lynn Smith, Miss Tulsa State Fair.
Good evening, I'm Candace Davis, Miss University of Oklahoma.
Good evening, I'm Christy Blue, Miss University of Tulsa.
And I'm Lori Young, Miss Western Plains.
There they are, Oklahoma's 48 reigning queens on parade.
Beauty, talent,
and poise are personified in your Miss Oklahoma 1989. After finishing in the top 10 at the Miss America pageant, she has traveled thousands of miles across the state and in different parts of the country and has won the hearts of many. Please welcome her home tonight. Tamara Harler, Miss Oklahoma 1989. You know, Oklahoma is lucky for so many things. We're very fortunate for the beautiful things our state has to offer. And part of that beauty belongs to the fact that we are the home of several Miss Americas. We would like for you to meet them tonight. Donna Axum Whitworth, Miss America 1964. Miss Arkansas, and she resides in Bartlesville. Miss America 1967, Laverne Zone, Jane Giroux. Jane, of course, won the Miss America title as Miss Oklahoma. She makes her home in Oklahoma City. And Miss America 1980, Cheryl Pruitt Salem. And Tulsa is her home.
Mignon, they gave me a microphone.
I was afraid of that. I figured you'd find a way.
Yes, I took it with me for fear you might snatch it from me.
No. Well, what do you have to tell us, Cheryl? Go ahead.
Well, it seemed quite appropriate. Here we have Jane and Donna, and I am here. And, you know, there's one more Miss America that has been here all week, and we have been celebrating her 10-year. And after 10 years, you don't celebrate at all because no one is supposed to know after 10 years how long ago it's been. And so we thought it'd be nice since she's been out to sing, but she hasn't been out with the old group. So we wanted to bring her out with the old group. Would you welcome Susan Powell, Miss America 1981. Happy anniversary to you.
photo opportunity. Speaking of, are we going to work with the photo all night? Yes, Susan says yes. For those of you keeping score during the week, I think it was Mignon Wednesday, Susan Thursday, and Friday. Yes, outcome yet to be determined. Now it's time to learn the names of our 10 finalists for 1990. The panel of judges started this week, a rustle through the crowd, interviewing our 48 contestants Monday evening and watched them perform in preliminary competitions in the area of onstage personality and evening gown, physical fitness swimsuit, and talent. The contestants were scored individually by each judge, and these points have been tabulated by certified public accountants. The 10 contestants with the highest number of collective points will compete again tonight. The remaining 38 contestants will receive $150 toward their education in addition to other awards. Now, except for the interview competition, all of the previously earned points have been discarded. Those interview points carry over into tonight's competition. Each contestant starts with a clean slate, though, in the other areas tonight. Contestant number 16, Miss Midwest City, Ducharme Carter. Contestant number 6, Miss Oklahoma City University, Amy Everett. Contestant number 15, Miss Lake Hudson, Deanna Luckinville. Contestant number 32, Miss Northwest Oklahoma, Corby Carlin. Contestant number 48, Miss Collinsville, Tamara Parkhurst. Contestant number 40, Miss Stroud, Cynthia White. Number 28, Miss Tulsa State Fair, Gina Lynn Smith. Contestant number 18, Miss Shawnee Jolynn Washington. Contestant number 34, Miss Norman, Cindy Wall. And contestant number 17, Miss Arkansas Valley, Keely Fry. One of these beautiful young ladies will be your next Miss Oklahoma 1990. Congratulations. We are up to the top of the Mabee Center tonight. How's the oxygen up there? All right. Well, and how's your vision tonight? Oh, no, I thought I wasn't going to be on there for a second. I have so enjoyed being here all week for the Miss Oklahoma pageant, and, you know, I've determined that one of the really nice things about not having to wear that crown again, that's been really nice, not having to wear the crown and not have to worry about it, and it's a good thing because if I had been asked to wear it, I couldn't. It's broken. No, I did not fall down and break my crown some years ago when I was Miss Oklahoma, but they are very delicate. In fact, Susan was telling me earlier in the week that her crown, she had broken her crown during her year. So it's, you know, it's not uncommon to do it. They really are very easy to break. You get out of a car with the crown on and you knock a tip off or something. Or in my case, taking a shower and I'd put my head back and hit that nozzle and just about did it every time. Of course, I don't think I have enough hair to hold it on there anymore, but very excited to be here tonight. We've had a wonderful week. How many have made it all single every night, all four nights? All right, well, you'll tell the others when to applaud. Right now, we want you to make some applause noise for a very fine group of dancers. They are Dance 2000 under the direction of Chris Monet and featuring Melinda Moore Phillips, Jennifer Young, and Jay Frankie. Dance 2000! Ten years ago, a beautiful young lady came to the Miss Oklahoma pageant from Elk City. She was wearing the Miss Oklahoma City crown at the time, and four nights later, she was Miss Oklahoma. It was off to Atlantic City in the Miss America pageant where she captured the hearts of everyone. Who can forget how beautiful she looked with the blue boa and the telephone in her ear and those eyes? Well, that young woman, of course, is Susan Powell, Miss America 1980. Please welcome her back tonight. 81, I'm sorry.
We had a little bit of a travesty tonight, other than that I did not wear a walking dress. I didn't know I was going to go down the runway. As you can see, I can't walk in this dress. It's a singing dress, not a walking dress. And then we have our sitting dresses, too. my husband, I had a travesty when I got here tonight. I have a pair of shoes that I want to wear in the second half, my silver shoes that go only with my dress that I'm wearing in the second half, and I only brought one of them. So. Boy, I should have said that in the opening thing. Wow, this is like a tryout for my material. Anyway, my husband went over to the hotel. I said, go get that shoe. So you should see our room, by the way. I mean, I've been on the road for 5 weeks, and with his junk and mine, well, basically I just tell the maid, I'm just give her my sympathies when she goes in there. But our room is really bad, and I can never find anything. I'm not a very organized person. So I sent my poor husband over there to find a silver shoe in the midst of all of that junk. So he found the shoe, he dug around and found the shoe, and he was a man in a tuxedo out in the parking lot of the Grandview Hotel carrying a silver shoe. and some big truck driver gets out of a car, a truck, a 15-wheeler, and says, let me guess, Cinderella. 15-wheeler, 18-wheeler, well, what the heck? Eighteen-wheeler, Bob Wheeler, I go, this is going down the tubes fast. No, hey, anyway, the guy says, let me guess, Miss America, no, let me guess, Cinderella. David said, no, better, Miss America. Hit it. And I did a little duet from a show we all know and love, and I said I wanted to repeat it tonight. I thought it would be fun for people who weren't here last night, because I know a lot more people are able to come on Saturday night. And this is a man that I met the first day of rehearsals of the musical Oklahoma in Cincinnati. My husband is from Traverse City, Michigan. He is a graduate of the University of Michigan, and this musical has actually been a big turning point every time he's performed it in his life. He was from a big, accomplished family, six kids, five boys, one girl, and they all wanted their kids to do whatever they wanted to do, a very liberal family. Well, David was a real brain and very good at school and wanted to be a lawyer, and then he tried out for the High School Musical, which was Oklahoma. And he got the lead, and he got the theater bug, and he got bit by the theater bug, and went into show business, and has had a wonderful career in show business, and has sung with opera companies all over America. And he's a one heck of a guy. David, get out here. Hit it.
Come them down the plain. And the way the wheat can sure smell sweet when the wind comes right behind the rain. Surrey, when I take you out in the Surrey with a fringe on the car. Watch that fringe, see how it flutters when I drive them high stepping strutters. Nosy folks into their shutters. Hello.
Imagine what it's like around their house. Good morning, dude. Well, now it is time for our competition to begin. The judges will evaluate our contestants in physical fitness swimsuit. 15% of her total score is gained in this competition. We begin with contestant number 16, Miss Midwest City, Jeremy Carter. Jeremy is 19 years old and the daughter of the late Milton Carter and Jimmy L. Carter of Oklahoma City. She'll be a sophomore at Oklahoma City University this fall and hopes to pursue a law degree in the future. Contestant number 6, Miss Oklahoma City University, Amy Everett. Amy is the 21-year-old daughter of A.B. and Pat Everett of Oklahoma City. She's a senior at Oklahoma City University, where she plans to obtain her Bachelor of Music and Bachelor of Arts degrees. Contestant number 15, Miss Lake Hudson, Deanna Luckinville. Deanna is 21 years old and the daughter of Dr. and Mrs. Dennis Luckinville of Enid. She's a graduate of Oklahoma City University with a Bachelor of Music degree. Contestant number 32, Miss Northwest Oklahoma, Corby Beth Carlin. Corby is 25 years old and the daughter of Dr. Milton and Eddie Carlin of Tulsa. She's a graduate of Oklahoma State University, where she received a Bachelor of Arts degree in speech communication. Contestant number 48, Miss Collinsville, Tamara Parkhurst. Tamara is 19 years old and the daughter of Steve and Linda Parkhurst of Tulsa. She's a sophomore at Oklahoma State University, where she plans to get a Bachelor of Science degree in Sociology and a Bachelor of Arts degree in Vocal Performance. Contestant number 40, Ms. Stroud, Cynthia White. Cynthia is 24 years old and the daughter of Lanny and Jan White of Oklahoma City. She's a graduate at the University of Oklahoma with a Bachelor of Business Administration in Accounting. Contestant number 28, Miss Tulsa State Fair, Gina Lynn Smith. Gina Lynn is the 20-year-old daughter of Jean and Lynn Smith of Stillwater. She's a junior at Oklahoma State University, where she plans to receive a bachelor's degree in business administration. Contestant number 18, Miss Shawnee, Jolynn Alicia Washington. Jolynn is 20 years old and the daughter of Reverend and Mrs. J.O. Washington of Denver, Colorado. She's a senior at Langston University seeking a Bachelor of Science degree in Criminal Justice and Corrections. Contestant number 34, Miss Norman, Cindy Wall. Cindy is 24 years old and the daughter of Dr. Richard and Betty Wall of Lubbock, Texas. She's a graduate of the University of Oklahoma, where she received a Bachelor of Arts degree in journalism. Contestant number 17, Miss Arkansas Valley, Keely Fry. Keely is the 19-year-old daughter of Robert and Mary Fry of Tulsa. She's a junior at Oklahoma State University, where she's seeking a Bachelor of Arts degree in broadcast journalism. Well, that's our physical fitness and swimsuit portion of tonight.
Now there are 9 more contestants backstage that can hear applause also, so let's give the all 10 a big round of applause. Well, you had a chance to hear a beautiful voice a little bit earlier. Please welcome back your Miss Oklahoma 1989, Tamara Marler.
Thank you. How many of you were here last night? Well, last night, Mignon and I planned a little surprise for everyone. Nobody had any idea we were going to do it. We sang Respect. Actually, I sang Respect, and Mignon pretty much jammed on Respect. And during the first song, I must have ripped my gown because I started feeling a breeze during the second song, all the way up my back. And this was one of those embarrassing moments, and there are many embarrassing moments that happen to you while you're in pageants. It's a very humbling experience. But I was singing, and I was planning on dancing with Mignon. And I'm just singing, and Mignon comes out there, and I start dancing. She thinks I'm playing a joke on her, that she's going to come out and act like some fool, and I'm going to act like I didn't even know what she was doing. And I said, she goes, dance with me! And she was just jiggling all around dancing, and I go, I can't. And she goes, she went back over, and she came back by me, and she goes, dance with me! I said, Mignon, I can't, my dress ripped! I had a white dress on and a black long line bra. I could just see me dancing all over the place. So I do have a safety pin on tonight to prevent that from happening. Another embarrassing moment happened with Mignon, and this was the first time I was ever in the Miss Oklahoma pageant, and it was when when Mignon was crowned Miss Oklahoma. And we were on the same preliminary night, and we were coming out in evening gown, and I mean, we were right there at those silver curtains, and Mignon was behind me. And of course, you know, I'd passed by probably 50 people, and Mignon said, what's that? And I was just standing there, feeling pretty cool. And Mignon said, that right there. And I was like, what? I was turning around looking. She goes, no, stop, that. So I turn around, I look. There's a bra hooked to the beads of my evening gown. And I'm getting ready to drag it out on stage with me, like I'm proud of it or something. And if that's not the worst of it, it was a big old padded bra. I knew it wasn't mine. I was wearing mine. This is the song that I sang at the Miss Oklahoma pageant and at the Miss America pageant. It's a very special song to me, and I'd like to dedicate it to you, my audience, because my life will never be the same since I fell for you. Hit it.
When you just give love and never get love, you'd better let love depart. I know it's so, and yet I know I can't get you out of my heart. You
I'm still in love.
Boy, she has a beautiful voice. Can you say bra in the Maybe Center? I really kind of think I should have gotten Miss Congeniality that year for my efforts there to keep her from going out with that bra, but because I put it there and then I felt guilty, I thought I better tell her. I realize the importance of the talent competition to the overall competition areas in the Miss America program and the Miss Oklahoma pageant. It is an extremely important phase of competition. The contestants will earn 40% of their score here with the talent presentations. We begin with contestant number 16, Miss Midwest City Duchermy Carter. From the Broadway musical New York, New York, Liza Minnelli introduced the song But the World Goes Round. Here to sing her rendition is number 16, Miss Midwest City Duchermy Carter.
Sometimes you're happy and sometimes you're sad, but the world goes around, and sometimes you'll lose every nickel you've had, but the world goes around. Sometimes your dreams get busted in pieces, but that doesn't matter.
Sometimes a truly great song comes back, but not necessarily as we remember it. Often there's a new style or a contemporary sound. Here, adding her special touch and flair, is contestant number 6, Miss Oklahoma City University, Amy Everett, singing Can't Help Loving That Man of Mine. I've got to love one man till I die. I can't help loving that man of mine. No, 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 no. Tell me he's lazy and tell me he's slow.
when it comes back. The day is
contestant borrows the excitement and emotion of some of the world's best-loved composers as she combines three popular classical themes in a medley for the piano. Here's contestant number 15, Miss Lake Hudson, Deanna Luckinbill, with Classical Overture. You've won a local pageant, you've won enough scholarship money to go to college, and now you find yourself about to perform your talent in front of 3,000 people. Well, you've got to ask yourself, how lucky can you get? Here to sing How Lucky Can You Get is contestant number 32, Miss Northwest Oklahoma, Corby Carlin.
A party where the fun never ends. You can circle the globe with my circle of friends. Someone I am crazy for is crazy for me. I'm his personal pet. Wow, how lucky can you get? Want to know what it's really like? Fantastic. Satin on my shoulder and a smile on my lips. Money in my pocket, right at my fingertips. Wrap it up and charge it, it's my favorite phrase. How lucky when I see the show, but think I'll give him a raise. How lucky! Life's a bed of roses, squirting perfume on me.
For the one you love sometimes means refusing to leave. In the hit Broadway musical Dreamgirls, the character of Effie fights for the love she so desperately needs by looking at the man she loves and singing the tragic and I am telling you I'm not going. Here with her own version of the powerful and emotion-filled song is contestant number 48, Miss Collinsville, Tamara Parkhurst.
And I am telling you, I'm not going. Your best man I'll ever know. There's no way I could ever go. No, no, no way. No, 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 no way. I'm living with her.
Steven Spielberg's heartwarming masterpiece, E.T., has become the most popular film of all time. The motion picture is filled with unparalleled imagination that has made audiences around the world laugh and cry as E.T. invites everyone to share the thrill of its magic touch. Contestant number 40, Miss Stroud, Cynthia White, will perform an arrangement of Themes from E.T., written by John Williams. Throughout his lifetime, Ira Gershwin composed many great songs. Here performing his last big hit, The Man That Got Away, is Gina Lynn Smith, contestant number 28, Miss Tulsa State Fair.
Suddenly you're over. must know that I'll live on night and day. Ever since this world began, there's nothing that can of one man, woman looking for.
We continue in talent now. The Splendid Preludes is performed for the first time by Gershwin in the early 20s, added to his reputation as the embodiment of American music. Just as Gershwin used his music as America's voice to the rest of the world, tonight, contestant number 18, Miss Shawnee Jolynn Washington, follows in those footsteps as she performs a rendition of Gershwin's Preludes in a medley. When we think of home, we think of a place where there's love overflowing, a place where there's peace, quiet, and serenity. Contestant number 34, Cindy Wall, Miss Norman, would like to take you on a journey home.
There's a chance for me to go back. that I have some direction. It sure would be nice to be back. In my life to grow up, time be my friend. Let me start again. So think my world don't change this face, but I still know where I'm going. Watched it growing. And oh, if you're listening, God, please don't make it hard to know if we should believe the things that we see. Tell us, should we try and stay? Or should we run away? Or would it be better just to let things let them be? And it's time.
The Broadway musical, Phantom of the Opera, recreates the most famous love triangle of all times. Christine Dye, the focal point in this triangle, is given the opportunity to audition for her first major role in an opera, a role inspired by her voice and written for her by her secret admirer, the Phantom. Judge this audition for yourself as contestant number 17, Miss Arkansas Valley, Healy Fry, recreates the sights and sounds of the beautiful aria, Think of Me.
Think of me fondly when we've said goodbye. Remember me once in a while. Please promise me you'll try. When you find that once again you long to take your heart back and to be free, if you ever find them all, spare a thought for
This year, instead of a prepared evening gown speech, each contestant was asked a question during the preliminary competition by Susan from her fact sheet during the onstage personality and evening gown. Tonight, the top 10 contestants will be asked questions from a critical issues essay they each submitted. 15% of the contestants' score is tallied in this onstage personality and evening gown. We begin with contestant number 16, Miss Midwest City Ducharme Carter.
Ducharme, what motivates people to volunteer their time to worthy causes?
I think that a person that volunteers their time is one who is a genuinely well-rounded person, one that is willing to say, "Send me to the hearts that have been broken so that healing can begin."
Thank you, Ducharme.
Contestant number 6, Miss Oklahoma City University, Amy Everett.
Amy, how might our adoption system be improved to preserve the self-esteem of adoptees?
I think there are certain areas that we do need to improve in the adoption system. Number one, I think that we need to, first of all, not move the adopted children. Keep them in that constant home where they can have the love and support that they desperately need.
Thank you, Amy.
Contestant number 15, Miss Lake Hudson, Deanna Luckinville.
Deanna, what has caused the deterioration of the American family unit?
I believe what has caused the deterioration of the family unit is that of not putting family as the number one priority in our lives. I want to thank my mother and father for the wonderful upbringing that they gave me and my 3 siblings. They sacrificed so much for us and gave us so much love that no matter what I do or what we all do, we know that we will succeed.
Thank you, Deanna.
Contestant number 32, Miss Northwest Oklahoma, Corby Beth Carlin.
Corby, how might public schools improve education for students with learning disabilities?
I think the primary issue is that we need to continue to allocate funds toward education, not only for the learning disabled, but for children in general. And then we have to realize how important the teacher's role is in helping children become a success, as well as parents' roles.
Thank you, Corby.
Contestant contestant number 48, Miss Collinsville, Tamara Parkhurst.
Tamara, how should our foster care system be improved?
I believe there are quite a few ways our foster care system can be improved. At this point, at age 18, foster care children are handed a bus ticket and the name of the nearest shelter. I believe by implementing a form of foster care where we can keep the children under care until age 21, as Illinois does voluntarily and New York does under a law, we could improve the foster care system and give these children the skills they need to survive in the world by age 21.
Thank you, Tamara.
Contestant number 40, Miss Stroud, Cynthia White.
Cynthia, how could the quality of daycare be improved to successfully supplement family care?
First of all, I think that we need to improve the pay which our daycare workers are receiving right now, because they have such a high turnover rate that it is hard to keep high-quality workers.
Thank you, Cynthia.
Contestant number 28, Miss Tulsa State Fair, Gina Lynn Smith.
Gina, what significant difference can one person make in protecting our environment?
One person can make a great deal of a difference in protecting our environment, because not only can that one person recycle their trash and stop using as much water, but they can influence the people that they are around every day in everyday life to also make the same changes that they are.
Thank you, Gina.
Number 18, Miss Shawnee Jolynn Alicia Washington.
Jolynn, how should colleges emphasize education in their athletic departments?
Oklahoma is a very athletic state, and in my critical issue, I made the suggestion that we as instructors, as recruiters, put more emphasis on athletics. Not saying that we go out and recruit those who are the best and the brightest, but that we recruit those saying that we'll give you the tools to help you make the grade. We have too many athletes in our colleges who just happen to be athletes going to school.
Thank you, Jolynn.
Contestant number 34, Miss Norman, Cindy Wall.
Cindy, how could we encourage our youth to be more aware of the significance of current events?
It's very easy to encourage our youth because they can make a difference in the world. I believe we can encourage them in the schools, teaching them that overthrowing a government is not what Alexis Carrington does in an hour, and realize that the most important events are happening right this minute.
Thank you, Cindy.
Contestant number 17, Miss Arkansas Valley, Keely Fry.
Keely, what should be done to reduce child abuse?
I think that reducing child abuse is going to have to begin in the homes. We have to teach our children what they are and how important that they are. And through that, they can grow up to be important people that won't abuse their own children. I think it's very important that we encourage our youth of today. Thank you.
Thank you, Keely.
And all the competitions for the title of Miss Oklahoma 1990. It won't be long now before we find out who's on the road to Atlantic City. The Miss America pageant will be held September 3rd through September 8th in Atlantic City. We would love for you to join us in supporting your Miss Oklahoma. If you're interested in making that trip, please call the Miss Oklahoma Scholarship Pageant Office.
I also want to say thank you to, and just give tribute to the people who are no longer here that were here 10 years ago, who aren't with us anymore. And Mary Lou Pyland, mainly Jack Campbell, who carried my luggage up and down the stairs at Francis House, and who treated me like one of their own, Laurie Sanders, the people who I thought would be here who aren't. Anyway, this song is for you and all of them.
Without a name for so long.
Paris, France, 1865. Deep underground in the tunnels of the city sewers lives a man, a brilliant musician, but one with a face and a soul terribly scarred and disfigured. He's established his lair directly beneath the Paris Opera House so he can hear every performance in the concert hall above. And one night he hears the voice of a young woman, Christine DeVoe, singing. He falls in love with that voice, becomes so completely obsessed with Christine that he ventures from his world of darkness into her world above. He kidnaps her, takes her back down with him into his cave of darkness below. There he declares his love and his conviction that a better life awaits Christine in the world of darkness and shadow with him. Meet the Phantom.
I am your angel of music. Come to me, angel of music. Nighttime sharpens, heightens each sensation. Darkness stirs and wakes imagination. Silently the senses abandon their defenses. Slowly, gently, night unfurls its splendor. Grasp it, sense it, tremulous and tender. Turn your face away from the garish light of day. Turn your thoughts away from cold, unfeeling light. And listen to my music of the night. Close your eyes and surrender to your darkest. Heard your thoughts of the life you lived before. Close your eyes, let your spirit start to soar, and you'll live as you've never lived before. Caress you, hear it, feel it, secretly possess you. Open up your mind, let your fantasies unwind. In this darkness that you know you cannot fight, the darkness of my music of the night.
pleasure. Touch, trust, savor each sensation. Let the dream begin. Let your darker side give in to the power of the music that I write. The power of my music of the song take flight. Help me make my music of the
A beautiful number to spotlight some beautiful contestants, don't you think? The Tony Spencer Miss Congeniality Award is voted on by the contestants, the onstage production staff, and the hostess committee in the dressing room area. The winner will receive a plaque and a $250 cash scholarship to the school of her choice from the Miss Oklahoma Local Pageant Directors Association, and she is contestant number 29, Miss Oklahoma State University, Tristy Welpley. It's my privilege to present the Quality of Life Scholarship Award brought to us by Fruit of the Loom, a major sponsor of the Miss America pageant. The Fruit of the Loom Quality of Life Award will be presented to one winner from each state, as well as a winner from the national pageant in Atlantic City. And these women have been selected because they have made significant contributions to improving the quality of life in their community through involvement in civic or charitable projects. A $1,000 scholarship from Fruit of the Loom goes to contestant number 15, Miss Lake Hudson, Deanna Luckinville. The Miss Oklahoma pageant has asked the judges to recognize those local pageant representatives who gave outstanding talent performances Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday nights. They are our non-finalist talent awards, and tonight we have six winners, each receiving a trophy and a $250 scholarship award. They are contestant number 11, Miss Oklahoma City, Dana Ogle. Contestant number 19, Miss Tulsa, Donna Huffman. Contestant number 23, Miss Nakoma Park, Michelle Masteller. Contestant number 38, Miss Enid, Michelle Rudd.
Contestant number 45, Miss Ardmore, Leanne Jones. And contestant number 47, Miss Lawton, Andrea Caldwell. The Mary Lou Pyland Rookie of the Year Award is presented to the first-year contestant who has scored the highest number of points during this week's competition. A $300 cash scholarship is presented in memory of Mary Lou Pyland, chairman of our hostess committee for many, many years. We are pleased to present this award to, and I'll need a card. Here we go. Stand-up dress, sit-down shoes. Walking not included. The Rookie of the Year Award goes to contestant number 28, Miss Tulsa State Fair, Gina Lynn Smith. Last year, beautiful, poised, and talented pop singer with the ambition of becoming a Supreme Court justice. I hope I don't ever have to practice in front of her. Completely captivated the judges. She was the representative of her local pageant as Miss Norman. Here she is making her final appearance as Miss Oklahoma 1989, Tamara Denise Toshiko Marler.
Thank you. I hope she doesn't ever have to practice in front of me either. I'll be going, bad hair. Good dress though. I like the dress. I wanted to say something very quickly before I sing my farewell song and before we listen to my farewell speech and I sit up here and blubber like an idiot. I wanted to say that I know you all probably came to watch someone special in your lives, and I want to tell you that they've been very special in my life, too. These contestants are exceptional in every way, whether or not they made top 10. The girls who sat back in the hospitality room are just as wonderful as the girls who made top 10. Tough to narrow this group down to 10. It's going to be tougher to narrow it down to 5. They're a fantastic group of contestants. You all have made my last week as Miss Oklahoma so very special. Thank you so much. The song I'm going to attempt to sing is called Glory of Love, and it's something that I've learned a lot about this year. And that is, you've got to give and you've got to take. Sometimes you win and sometimes you lose. But what's important through all of that is the glory of love. Hit it, please. Until the clouds roll by a little. 4.5 years, I have lived in a world that has taught me many valuable lessons. I look at the Miss America program as life in a capsule with concentrated doses of fantasy and reality combined into one entity. For me, that capsule served as a cure for the low self-esteem, self-confidence, and regard for others I once terminally suffered. For today, when I look in the mirror, I'm proud of who I see. In the interest of time, I cannot possibly thank the countless supporters I have encountered along my pageant path, but I would like to thank all of you collectively for touching my life in very significant ways. Thank you especially, Kiwanis Club of Tulsa, for your sponsorship and support of the Miss Oklahoma pageant. Without you, all of this would not be possible. To all of my preliminary pageant directors and coaches, Lake Eufaula, Tulsa, Tulsa State Fair, and Norman, thank you so much for believing in me and encouraging me. Without your unique contributions to my development, I would never have been Miss Oklahoma. Kathleen Pettigrove, you've been my director, friend, mentor, and confidant. Always understanding, loving, caring, and encouraging, you had a wonderful way of letting me be me, while ever so subtly letting me know when I needed to change. You always believed in me and stood up for me, and you never expected me to be anything but myself. Thanks also to Ben, Kristen, Andrea, and Elisa for being my enthusiastic supporters. Sherry Lewis, you've made such an incredible impact on my life. I've learned countless lessons from you. While obviously significant, your vocal help has been the least of our relationship. You've taught me to make no excuses, to aim high, work hard, and to be the ball. I will always remember all that you've done for me. Greg Entwistle, you're a lifesaver. I never knew the journey into real life could be so ugly until I encountered the IRS. But you've been my robo-accountant, fearless, determined, invincible in the evil realm of taxes. Thanks also to Connie and Elizabeth for sharing you with the Miss Oklahoma pageant. Your involvement has been so valuable. Dan, whether or not you believe it, I do consider you a dear friend. Even though you can be quite obnoxious at times, I also know that anytime I need you, you'll be there. You've proven it time and again. Thank you for adding comic relief to an exhilarating, sometimes hectic year. And thank you to Susie and Elizabeth for inviting me into your home and for keeping Dan in line. Marge, you're the world's greatest roommate. Your words of wisdom and shoulder to cry on proved to be a great oasis to me during a long, hot summer. And your patience with history's messiest Miss Oklahoma is greatly appreciated. Jeannie McNamara, you've been an inspiration to me in many areas of my life. Our discussions on those long road trips have helped me to see a new perspective on so many issues. Your constant encouragement and your faith in me has helped me to be all I want to be. Max, Richard, and all the stage crew, thank you for making us all look and feel wonderful. And thanks to Marlene, Cindy, and their merry band of redcoats for taking care of us throughout Miss Oklahoma Week. Bill and Carol Sanders, I've always admired you for your strength and faith through trying times. You are a living proof that with strong character and belief in God, we can overcome all things. You've helped me realize we should face adversity with the faith that through all trials, there is a reason. I sincerely hope and pray that you find that reason, for I know you will use it to light up the lives of many others in need. Lisa Mignon and Lori, I've tried to live up to the high standards you have set as Miss Oklahomas. While you are all strong in many ways, you will most be revered for those qualities which leave a unique impression on our hearts and memories. Thank you for being such shining examples for me to strive to follow. The Lord has blessed me with the love and support of a wonderful family. Mom, Tom, Dad, Christiana, Jan, Sin, Kim, Chuck, and everyone else, we've stuck together through the good times and the bad and supported each other as we grew in unique directions. You had to wonder if your bratty, insecure baby girl would ever amount to anything. I stand here tonight as an adult, a piece of each of you deep within me. I hope you are as proud of me as I am of you. Thank you so much for your belief that no matter the outcome, I was always your Miss America. Although not all of you could be here tonight, I know you're always here in spirit. Kay, you have shown me that our accomplishments are not for recognition or reward, but for the personal gratification we feel when we have truly helped another. You are the most beautiful person I know. It goes so much deeper and is much more enduring than surface beauty, because your warmth and compassion emanates from within. Thank you for caring so much about your job as executive administrator. By the way, good title. Gary, your advice and support has meant the world to me, as has your friendship.
Ashley and Tracy, you've been great little sisters. I look forward to watching you learn and grow into young women, and to the day you can wear hanging pierced earrings. You are both talented and unique individuals. Always believe in yourselves, as I believe in you. Carolyn, you're the epitome of grace, charm, beauty, and poise. You are Charlie's supreme angel. Thank you for being a beautiful symbol of femininity. Charlie, you took me under your wing when I was a frightened, intimidated, naive college dropout and helped me with everything from finding garages to fix my car to finding motivational classes to fix my self-image. Because of your influence, I am everything I always wished I would be and never believed I could. Although you may sometimes wonder if you created a monster because our strong opinions don't always match, I feel you respect me for standing up for my beliefs, as I have always respected you for expressing yours. As a parent with a child feels the urge to resist letting her go, so must you feel when you watch your Miss Oklahomas grow in their own directions. Your fatherly influence came along at exactly the right time in my life, and I know that without your guidance, I would not be the person I am today. The Miss Oklahoma pageant is so fortunate to have you and your undying support, and I thank you for believing in me. Jeff, our love transcends mere words. I thank God for bringing you back into my life. I look forward to spending the rest of eternity with you. And to Miss Oklahoma 1990, I wish you a year full of happiness and fond memories as I have had. Get ready for life in a capsule. Take it with a spoonful of sugar or a grain of salt, but take it. It will cure what ails you. As Miss Oklahoma, my goals have been simple ones at which I've worked very hard: to make a difference and to create an even better environment in which the contestants are given the opportunity to grow, prosper, and develop their unique individual inner selves, to do what is right and to be true to themselves. I hope I will be remembered as a great Miss Oklahoma, but most of all, I hope I will be remembered as being true to myself, my beliefs, and God. I hope I've made a difference.
Tamara Marler, Miss Oklahoma 1989. If she runs backstage and puts those flowers in the refrigerator, she can save a fortune on her wedding in a couple of weeks.
Well, Mignon?
Yes?
The judges have cast their ballots, and at this moment, they are being tabulated by the auditors. Before we get to that all-important decision, let's review our finalists. One of them will be Miss Oklahoma for 1990. Miss Midwest City.
DeShermie Carter sang, "But the World Goes Round."
Miss Oklahoma City University.
Amy Everett sang, "Can't Help Loving That Man."
Miss Lake Hudson.
Deanna Luckinbill played a classical overture.
Miss Northwest Oklahoma.
Corby Carlin sang, "How Lucky Can You Get?"
Miss Collinsville.
Tamara Parker sang, "And I Am Telling You I'm Not Going."
Miss Stroud.
Cynthia White played Themes from E.T.
Miss Tulsa State Fair.
Gina Lynn Smith sang "The Man That Got Away."
Miss Shawnee.
Joel Lynn Washington played Gershwin's Prelude No. 3.
Miss Norman.
Cindy Wall sang Home.
And Miss Arkansas Valley.
Keely Fry sang Think of Me.
The moment of decision has arrived. Susan, will you hand me the result? The fourth runner-up and winner of the $2,000 Sylvie Insurance Company Scholarship is contestant number 16, Miss Midwest City, Ducharme Carter. The third runner-up and winner of the $3,000 CMI Corporation and Victor B. Graff in memory of Irma Graff Scholarship is contestant number 34, Cindy Wall, Miss Norman. The second runner-up and winner of the $5,000 Mid-Continent Casualty Company Scholarship is contestant number 28, Miss Tulsa State Fair, Gina Lynn Smith. The first runner-up and the winner of a $10,000 Phillips Petroleum Company Scholarship is contestant number 6, Miss Oklahoma City University, Amy Everett. One of these six young ladies is our new Miss Oklahoma. Whomever she may be, the remaining five semifinalists will each receive a trophy and a $1,000 cash scholarship to the school of her choice. The winner of a $15,000 scholarship from the Kiwanis Club of Tulsa Foundation Incorporated in memory of Cheston S. Heath and the use of a 1990 Dodge donated by East Tulsa Dodge for the duration of her reign. Here to present the keys, Mr. Henry Hill. You're not to present the... No, Henry's here. Here comes Henry. Do you think he'd mind if I went ahead and announced it? Would you mind? All right. Your new Miss Oklahoma 1990 is contestant number 40, Miss Stroud, Cynthia White. Cynthia White, Miss Oklahoma, 1990.